We're back. All right, 10 miles, 16 kilometers in the Hoka Carbon Rocket. And I just got to say this right now. Hold on, let me just move this light. Basically, I am thinking it's going to be very, very difficult for any other shoe in 2019 to beat the upper on this Hoka Carbon Rocket. Hoka, you nailed the upper through the Carbon Rocket. I'm still pretty baffled by the zero drop, and then also I cannot lock down my heel real well in the heel cup area back here through the collar. This is called the collar of the shoe. So, but the upper is just treating me real, real nice. Okay, just a busy Monday, getting everything done, getting ready for the live stream tonight with Andy Wacker. In case you missed it, go check it out, upper right-hand corner. He was a sub 15-minute 5K guy in high school. So all the high schoolers out there, you might want to check it out. And then also, he runs professionally now for Nike. So upper right-hand corner, that card that pops out, click on that, and I think you'll enjoy it. All right. Keep rolling, keep rolling, keep your day rolling. Oh yeah, keyword, honesty. Keyword, honesty. We're gonna get into that in a little bit. All right, we are out and about getting everything done for the day, and yes, sending out a few more pairs of shoes today to Mario and Marcelo, congratulations. And also, let's see, I went to Walmart, and remember yesterday I talked about the aid stations for the marathon in Cleveland. Berry Blast Powerade is going to be the drink at the aid station. So yes, let the practicing begin. Paper cups and Powerade, like I am not kidding around when it comes to figuring out how to efficiently move through these aid stations in Cleveland. And also had to stop by Goodwill. I try to jump in to Goodwill's all around Denver, you know, maybe like twice a month. You never know what you're gonna find. So sure enough, look at that, and a Hoka Challenger ATR3, and I don't know how many miles it has on it, but I'm guessing by looking at the outsole, it's about 30 to 40 is my guess. This shoe, it's a size 12, so I will put this into the next giveaway. $15. It looks pretty darn good. Like I can tell the midsole still has some pretty good life to it. So anyway, all right, let's go in, get these shoes out the door for Mario. Whoa. Mario and Marcelo. About to go live with Andy Wacker. Got the microphone here. We don't need the mic for this video, so I'm just gonna set that aside. And yes, this is a little bit of a tough topic, being honest with ourselves when training for a peak race. And I'll be frank, everybody, there's no way I would have brought this topic up 4 or 5 months ago when the vlog really started taking off. And basically, I was just getting to know all of you. And through the question of the day, through the comments down below, I think we have slowly begun to figure out, like, just like reading your comments every single day, I'm slowly learning about your life and about your training style and the races that you like to run. And it is so amazing that we can do that here on YouTube. But now, 4 or 5 months into questions and comments and going back and forth and the live streams like what's happening tonight where we can just continue to dialogue in person but as live as possible, it's exciting. So today I was just thinking, gosh, we're almost to the quarter mark, right, of 2019. So January, February, March, it's, you know, it's like we're a lap into 2019. So I think it's a good moment to, yes, be honest with ourselves and really evaluate the training that we have done thus far in preparing for our track season. For all the high schoolers and college students out there, like, It's about to go down. The outdoor track season is about to go down. The marathon racing season is about to go down. All across the world, whether it's London, whether it's Boston, and many, LA. I think LA was yesterday. Yeah, LA was yesterday. So anyway, I'm excited to be honest with you about how I feel my training is going thus far in 2019. And you know how it goes. At the beginning of a new year, we can get excited, sometimes maybe overly excited for the upcoming year of racing and not always remembering, oh man, this is going to require quite a bit of training to get ready for these races. But, and also setting new goals and new PRs. And you know how I do it. Like, I've broken down how I set up my racing calendar for an entire year. And I think it's a really, really good thing. As long as we keep in mind, okay, time to put in the work. Time to get down to business with getting fit, putting in the workouts, and yes, going to the gym, all the little stuff, going to the gym, the stretching, the nutrition, the sleep, all of those little things to make sure we arrive on the starting line as fit and as fresh as possible. Okay, here's how I feel my 2019 is going thus far with respect to being honest with myself for training. Fitness-wise, I think I'm on point. I think I'm feeling fit. I'm feeling like I've gotten some really, really good vertical into my legs, some good altitude training into my lungs. I feel really good. So that's kind of a given. Like, you've watched me train over the last 3 months. It's just kind of a given. I've done a solid, I feel like a solid base layer of aerobic development. And now the question becomes, Seth, can you get ready for a fast road marathon? So I'll be honest, right? That's the topic of today. If I don't do a track workout this week, that will be dishonest in my preparation for Cleveland. I know for a fact I need to hit a track this week. And so that's the goal. Thursday is to get on the track for an introductory speed session, interval session. It's just going to be very introductory. Nothing. I'm not going to go out and do mile repeats, but I know it is time to begin to say not goodbye completely to the mountains, but just to say, okay, time to back off the vertical gain a little bit and start to work on going faster. So that's one thing where I know I need to do that this week. And then also, last week I skipped out on my plyometrics. My legs were tired, and listen, you gotta walk that line, you gotta listen to your body, but I went big on Mount Morrison on Monday, so a week ago actually, and yeah, it made my legs tired for the rest of the week, and I knew they would be tired, I wasn't sure how tired, and so that's just where I'm at. I feel a little bad not hitting the plyometrics last week. I know that it is a really important part of staying healthy and also working on that foot speed and that going fast speed for the road marathon distance. And so again, the key word is honesty, because I just want to remain honest to the training plan, remain honest to the goals that I've set before myself, and make sure that I'm doing all the little things possible to make sure I achieve my goal. And so the question of the day, do you ever stop in a training block and hit the pause button, look in the mirror, and ask yourself, am I doing everything possible in my control to achieve the desired outcome for a race, and specifically a peak race? Do you do that? Is that part of your training and your mental preparation for a race? And I know this is kind of, you know, opening up a can of worms with respect to going inside and thinking and evaluating, but I think it's a good thing. I think it's a really good thing to reflect and make and just pause. And especially since we're almost 3 months into 2019, I think it's a good opportunity to open this door and think about it. All right, that's the question of the day. All right, I'm not signing off quite yet. Stay tuned. I'm going to interview Andy Wacker live, and then I'm going to talk to you about how it went, and then we'll do the wrap-up in a minute. All right, here we go. Andy, take it away. And there you have it. Good times in the studio with Andy Wacker. That was amazing. Interviewed him live for about an hour. we talked about a lot. Oh man, talked about his sub 15 minute 5K in high school and what worked for him for training in high school. Talked about being recruited into college, what it was like to run under Mark Wetmore, and then also talking about his running for Nike now and how Andy's really interesting because he's very successful on the trails, but he's also very fast on the roads. So we talked about his different training for doing both disciplines within the long distance running world and the different types of shoes that he likes to run in and race in for Nike. So if you haven't seen it, upper right hand corner, I think you'll enjoy listening to Andy's interview. And let's see, tomorrow is a big workout for me. It's going to be a lot of miles. I won't tell you how many miles, but I'm going to warm up in the Pegasus 35 and then put on the Reebok Float Ride Run Fast Pro for the actual threshold run, and then finish off with a middle distance run in the Adios 4. So it's going to be a good day tomorrow. Make sure you come back for that. And yes, again, shout out to Goodwill for the good find here, the Hoka Challenger ATR 3. I will be doing, so the next giveaway, mark your calendars, is going to be Monday, April 1st, 7 p.m. Mountain Time. Monday, April 1st, I'll promise you this, we'll give away at least 10 pairs of shoes, okay? So at least 10 pairs of shoes, all some of them brand new, some of them gently used, and these are going to be in the gently used category, but $15 from Goodwill, I couldn't pass it up. And we will be doing the regular, just so you know, we'll be doing the regular live stream Wednesday night. So when you're, so tomorrow, when you're watching this Tuesday, tomorrow, 7 p.m., just for our normal weekly hangout here on YouTube. All right, I don't know if I'm going to film anything else tonight. In case that's it, I'm going to sign off, and we'll just be back tomorrow. Does that sound good? That's a fun day in the books. Oh, thank you again, Andy, for taking the time. Seek beauty, work hard, and love each other. See you tomorrow.